foreclosure signs sprouting up in gated communities like Silicon Valley. California's rich are walking away from multi-million dollar properties, defaulting on their mortgages at alarming rates, way beyond that of average homeowners. That's according to a survey conducted by the New York Times. It found more than 1 in 7 homeowners with loans of more than $1 million are seriously delinquent. But it may not be for the same reasons as average homeowners. Joining us now to explain what could be going on here is retirement phase expert Phil Cannella, founder of the First Senior Financial Group. Welcome to you, sir.
Thank you, Joyce.
Well, the data is suggesting that many well-to-do people might be dumping their expensive properties on purpose. Why would they do that?
Well, simply put, Joyce, these are people who are affluent people that have the resources and already have a home that they're living in. So these second homes, these vacation homes, why would they want to keep them when they can simply walk away from a bad investment? Makes sense.
So they're just saying, you know what, I can afford to just leave this and walk and, you know, no more water being put into this barrel.
Absolutely. The average person in this country, it's their greatest asset is the equity in their home. These people cannot walk away from their house. It's their shelter. It's where they're bringing up their families. But the rich and the affluent, again, can afford to do this. These are second homes, vacation homes, or even investments. Why wouldn't they walk away if an investment's going bad and there's no consequence for them?
Wow, what would happen to those homes? The bank will sell them?
Well, this is why you had in 07, two banks go under. In 08, 25 banks went under, Joyce. And in 09, it's alarming. 140 banks went under. And this year alone, we are at a run rate of banks going under to over 305. When people do not pay their debt, banks collapse. I call that the stick house industry, the banking industry. It's collapsing. You need to pay your debt to a bank or banks are going to collapse. And if consumers are not paying debt, I say there's a much larger group of people struggling to pay debt. And if 70% of this economy depends on consumer spending, we're in for a long haul here.
And some of those people you specialize in, retirement, working with older Americans, explain what you do and why you do it.
Well, first of all, I believe in what we're doing. Our mission at our firm, or anyone's mission as a financial advisor, should be to help crash-proof the American retiree's portfolio or their nest egg. These are people who built the backbone of this country. And it is possible to have a crash-proof retirement. Again, our mission is we say that the financial industries in this great country, Joyce, are stacked against the very people who built it. That would be the American retiree. There are five flaws that they have no control over. And one big flaw is you can't safeguard all you work for in the September of your years by keeping it at market risk.
So real quickly, tell us what people in their 50s and 60s should be thinking about doing right now.
Right now, they should realize that there's a sea of risk out there, and we are in one of the greatest economic storms that this country's ever seen in 300 years. And what they should be doing is seeking out a retirement phase expert. These are financial advisors that will be accountable to you in your retired years, in which they can offer you guarantees with investment accounts that do not go into bankruptcy, but yet can give you the greatest earning potential for double-digit returns without any market risk. There are lots of financial vehicles for people in retired years that they can be satisfied with and safeguard their accounts. But the problem, Joyce, here is many financial advisors have not been taught these retirement phase vehicles, and therefore many consumers are unaware of them.
You've got some more tips. Your book is free. We're going to put this stuff on our website. Thank you so much, Phil Cannella, for coming in. We hope to see you soon.
Thank you, Joyce, for having me.
All right, take care.